watched Kamala Harris's first interview today, her first since she became the nominee almost 6 weeks ago. And this was the preview CNN was playing ahead of that interview.
The climate crisis is real, that it is an urgent matter to which we should apply metrics that include holding ourselves to deadlines around time. We did that with the Inflation Reduction Act.
It basically sums up Kamala Harris's ongoing obsession with word salads and burdening Americans with her bizarre jargon. But what struck me the most is that she needed a babysitter with her. Why on earth was Tim Walz, her vice presidential pick, there? Did she need an emotional support person? Did she need reassurance? I mean, she is the one who is running for president, not him, yet he spent most of the interview sat there like a spare part. And bear in mind, this interview was a long time coming. Kamala Harris has refused to do any interviews or press conferences since the Democrat elite punted old Joe Biden in favour of her. Therefore, there have been zero opportunities to properly scrutinise her and her policies, or lack thereof. She's avoided it. And today she does her first interview, pre-recorded, so not live, and therefore we don't know how much was edited and cut out. She chose a network where most Democrats feel at home, CNN, one of the most liberal media outlets in America, you know, the same one that covered up Joe Biden's cognitive decline for years.
President Biden, who I've been around numerous times just in this last year, is sharp, he's focused, he's bright.
I was in almost every meeting with the president, and the president was in front of and on top of it all.
He is good in small settings, yes. And he's a good small talker, and he puts you at ease if you're in a small group with him.
And the journalist, CNN's Dana Bash, who has shown extreme pro-Democrat rhetoric on multiple occasions. But the bizarre thing is, Kamala Harris could not do the interview alone. She had to do it with Tim Walz. And look at the optics of this. They are sitting at a black table, like they're about to break bread and have lunch, except, of course, this is actually meant to be a serious interview setup. Yet Kamala looks small and just awkward in the middle. And if you look closely, Tim Walz's collar is not even sitting right. And while Kamala takes most of the questions, Walz is left there to look around, and all he can really do is nod his head. At times so violently, I thought he would even pull a muscle. The optics are so off. And it suggests that this woman, who wants to be the president of the United States, is unable to do solo interviews, unable to stand up for herself, and has generally no idea what to do when not staring at an autocue. And when she does an interview, she has to have a babysitter. She needs someone holding her hand. Now, the strategy of staying silent has worked so far for Kamala Harris. She is slightly ahead of Trump in the latest national polling, 48 to 45. The real test, though, will come on September 10, when she faces off with Donald Trump in a presidential debate with no autocue and no babysitter.